can't ever have too much sauce. Hey guys, welcome to my kitchen. I'm Jamison, and this is how I cook. Are you looking for something different for maybe Sunday dinner, Easter dinner, Resurrection Sunday dinner? Let me show you how to make lamb shanks up next on This Is How I Cook. Hey guys, before we get too far into the ingredients, do me a favor, hit that subscription button and turn on those notifications. It'll help you stay in touch with my channel when I drop new videos. So the star of our show are these beautiful lamb shanks. They come from the lower part of the lamb's leg. So when you see the leg of lamb, these come from the very bottom towards the narrow part. We've got our seasoning, salt and pepper. We've got some bay leaf. We've got some crushed dried rosemary. We've got some beefy onion, Lipton's soup mix. We've got some garlic powder. We've also got some olive oil, a little bit of butter for the browning process. And we've got a secret ingredient, which isn't that all that secret. We've got some leftover red wine that we're gonna use as part of our braising liquid. So we start by coating the lamb shanks in a little bit of olive oil. This will help our seasoning adhere to these shanks. Next thing we want to do is season these generously with a little bit of salt. Come back with our black pepper. Some dry rosemary here. This is crushed dry rosemary. And then we want to use our garlic powder. And those are seasoned lamb shanks. The next step is you want to preheat your oven to 400 degrees. So for our next step, we need to brown our lamb shanks. And so to do that, I'm going to use my cast iron enameled pot. It has a heavy bottom and is going to help prevent the fond that develops as the meat browns from burning in the pot. So I'm going to start my fire and get my pot going here. And I'm putting in probably about a tablespoon and a half of butter. The butter's for the flavor. And then also I'm gonna add in about 2 tablespoons of olive oil. And now that we've got some sizzle for my butter, I'm gonna add our first lamb shank. And I'm gonna do this one at a time. And I'm gonna give this a chance to start sizzling so that we can then know when we can start adding the other ones in. So that's how I can tell how hot the pot is, by putting the first one in and letting it go for a little bit until it starts to brown. And all we're trying to do here, we're not trying to cook the shanks all the way to completeness. All we're trying to do is get some color onto the shank. So that's about where we want to be, but we want that all over the shank can. Now my next step is I'm gonna add in some red wine. That deglaze is the pan. This is about a cup of red wine. So our next ingredient is that we're gonna add in some bay leaf. I'm gonna put a couple in here. I don't mind the taste of bay leaf at all. I like it in these type of braising situations. So I'm gonna put in 4. Next thing we wanna do is we wanna add in some Lipton onion soup mix. This is beefy onion. And I'm gonna add in I'm gonna add in 2 packs. So what you wanna do now is just come in again and sort of just work all this together. So we just come in with some water. And we wanna pour just enough of this in here. Actually, I'm not gonna cover them all the way. I'm just gonna leave them with just enough liquid shy of covering them. And then I'm gonna come back in with a little bit more pepper at the very end. Now notice I didn't put any salt into this liquid. other than what comes in those seasoning packs for the soup. And the reason why I did that is because I want to season with salt at the very end. And while your oven preheats, you want to wait till your braising stock and your shanks come back up to temperature and begin to boil. You don't have to have them come to a rolling boil, but we want to give the braising a head start by warming up the stock that's associated in the pot here with the shanks. And so we're going to take this, put it into the middle of the oven, and we're going to allow the oven to cook for about probably 2 hours for these shanks. But, you know, it's all about how tender you want your shanks to be. So, well, you'll check them after about an hour and a half with yours at home, and you can tell based on the texture of the meat and also the amount of reduction if you're at the place where you want to stop or continue to cook your shanks. So our shanks, including the stock, has come back up to a boil. So at this point in time, I'm going to take them off the fire, open up my oven, and put them inside. Okay, these lamb shanks have been in the oven for 2.5 hours at 400 degrees. And so I want to see exactly how tender they are. And what we start by doing is just taking a look and see they're pretty much just falling apart here. See how tender that is? So our lamb shanks are beautifully tender. And now what I'm going to show you as the last step is how to reconstitute this beautiful reduction in the pan so that we can make our sauce or our gravy. So I've got my pot with this beautiful reduction in it. And what I'm going to do is make a sauce to finish these lamb shanks with. This is too salty because it's become concentrated. So what we want to do is thin this down, but I do want some viscosity. And so what I'm going to do is sprinkle in some flour right here into our pot. I'm going to put in 1.5 tablespoons. Let's make it 2 tablespoons of flour. So I've got my pot on a medium flame. And what I'm going to do now is just whisk in this flour. Into the reduction that we've made. And if you haven't already, this is the time to remove your aromatics like the bay leaf. See, there's one right there. And it shouldn't take long for this to start back bubbling. And you see how thick this has become? And so the last thing we have to do is just add in some water, a little bit at a time, gradually whisking it in. And you just keep adding the water until your sauce becomes the consistency that you like. And that is our sauce to finish our beautiful lamb shanks. So now all we have to do is take a beautiful ladle full of this beautiful sauce, gravy, and just spread it over our lamb shanks. Can't ever have too much sauce. Make this pretty. And this is great, obviously, with rice or some other type of starch to absorb this beautiful sauce and the juices from the lamb. But that is how I make lamb shanks. Okay, guys, let's give this lamb a try. I'm gonna start with one of these nice chunks of meat and make sure I get some of this beautiful sauce that I've put on the plate. Let's see how this tastes. Oh! Man! Woo! First thing you notice is just how tender these lamb shanks have become. You've got a flavor that jumps out at you from the garlic, the rosemary, the salt and pepper, obviously. The beefy onion soup mix is just a perfect accompaniment in terms of the base of the sauce. to help give this gravy, this sauce, a beautiful beefy flavor, but it doesn't overpower the lamb. And then the red wine that we use, it has a very subtle hint of wine popping through the sauce, complementing the flavors, not only from the beefy onion soup mix, but obviously the natural flavors of the lamb. This is grass-fed lamb, so this is exceptionally good because you get the wonderful notes from the lamb's diet when the animal was grazing. This is perfect. I hope you try this on your Easter Sunday, Resurrection Sunday. Hope you try this on any weekday that you want a beautiful dinner. Guys, thank you for watching my channel. I'm Jamison, and this is how I cook. I've got to get back to these lamb shanks, because this is going to, I don't know if this is going to make it to be my lunch and dinner for tomorrow. Y'all take care.